Hi guys, I'm Yinki. You're welcome to another interesting class. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make Zara cap, and I use Aso-oke to make one. You can see the picture of what I just made with the Aso-oke. And what you need to make this type of cap is just your Aso-oke and the mako. This mako is a type of material that you can get from people selling shoemaking materials, bag making materials, and so on. That's where you can get the mako. And this is the Aso-oke I'm going to use for the cap itself. And the length is, it depends on how you want it, 12 inches by 25 inches. The 12 inches is for the width and the 25 inches is for the length. And you can also make it as much as 18 inches for the width. It depends on how much ruffles you want inside the cap. So, and this one is for the bow. There is a bow at the back, and I'm going to use 6 inches by 20 inches, 6 inches for the width and 20 inches for the length. So you're going to get two pieces so that you'll be able to turn it. I'm going to sew around like so, like you are making a belt. Then here I'm going to leave a space to turn it out to the right side. And this is the bow knot. It is 6 inches by 3 inches, 3 inches for the width and 6 inches for the length. So I'm going to turn this out right. I have sewed this one, so I'll just turn it out to the right side through this opening. So that opening, by the time I turn it out, I can hem it or stitch it. So I'm just trying to turn it out here. So you turn it out to the right side. And this is what we have right now. This is what I'll be using for the bow. So I'm trying to bring it out, to turn it out, so as to turn it to the right side. So this is it. It has been turned to the right side. Then this is the opening that I used to turn it. Then I'll just hem it with my hand needle or stitch it down. So I have the material for my bow ready. And the next thing I'm going to do is to fold it into two, because I want it to be into two. I want to double it. So I'll fold it into two and create the knot like so. It's either you fold it like this, or there's another way you can fold it so that both ends will be folded, will be a folded end like so. So you can let it meet at the center like this. I think this is preferable. So I'll just let it meet at the center like this, and here I'll hold it together with a stitch, with a straight stitch. I'll hold it together. So I'll just stitch it with a straight stitch. And after I have stitched it, then I'll come and repair my bow. So this is the knot. This is how I'm going to wrap it. I'll be showing you this later on, by the time I wrap it. So the first thing I'll do is to join it at the center, just to join it together like so. After I have joined it with a straight stitch, so that both ends of the bow will be folded ends, and it makes it a little more neater and professional. So then I'll go ahead now and create my bow. So I want to check the measurement. So I have 10 inches by 5 inches, in case you don't want to fold your own bow. So that's why I took the measurement again, so that you will know what you need. And this is the knot. So this is what I will use to knot it. I'm trying to stitch it. I fold the 3 inches into 2, so that I will have something like 1 inch or like 1.5 inch. By the time I sew it, I will have 1 inch left. So 1 inch is the width right now after stitching. Then I'm going to gather it together at the middle, then use the knot to use this to knot it at the middle, at the center. So as you can see, it's the normal way we create our bow, so like our bow tie. So just create it, then use your hand needle to gather it together, just to stitch this end like so. So just use the hand needle to tack it down, so that it will not shift. The bow will just remain the way you made it. So after I have done that, my bow is ready. So I will now attach it. This is the side I'm going to attach. So then I'll move to my marker. So I'm going to take the measurement of 18 inches length for the marker, and I'll take 3.5 inches width, and that is what I'm taking. 18 inches length and 3.5 inches width. So I checked again to confirm. So after, you can also make it 3 inches, it depends on how wide you want it to be. So I made my own 3.5 inches. So then I'll go ahead and cut it out. After I have cut it out, this is the length. Remember, the head circumference is around 22 inches and 23 inches. So just make this one 18 inches so that it will not be up to that head circumference. So then get the center. The center is what I just marked on the marker. So I'll get the midpoint on the marker. And after I have gotten the midpoint on the marker, I'll place it on the midpoint on the main fabric I'm using for the cap itself. And this is the main fabric I'm using for the cap itself. So I'll place it on it like so. Then, can you see this is Aso-oke. So I have two of it before, because Aso-oke is always in pieces, like 6 inches width. That's how, if you have seen Aso-oke, that's how they make it. There are some that are in pieces like that, and there are some that are not in pieces like that. For those that are in pieces like that, you need to, like, 2-3 of it can do a Zara cap, or 2 also can do it. It depends on how much ruffles you want on the inside of the cap. So, but for this tutorial, I'm using 3 of it. That 3, 6 inches will now give me 18 inches altogether. So I will fold the part I will be using for the marker. So that's the band part. That's the cap band. So I'm trying to fold it up so that I will stitch it down, and I'll be able to place the marker inside. Marker is just to hold the band on the head, just to make it voluminous. There are some other materials you can use for this. You can use your stiff, but your stiff will not be handy. Your stiff will not be that handy like marker. That's why I'm using the marker, but your stiff can also do it. So I'm going to place it at the center. So I have marked the center. So you're going to centralize the marker on the center of the Aso-oke that you are using for the cap. So by the time you centralize it, you are going to have allowance on both sides. Allowance that will be left on both sides will be around maybe 3 inches. So I'll just place it inside like so. I'll fold it and place it in and push it inside. Then by the time you are pushing it, make sure you centralize it so that it will fall in the middle. So I have put it inside. Because I chopped it before I place it in, I know the middle. So I have centralized it so that allowance will be on both sides. So you can use other materials apart from Aso-oke for this type of cap. You can use your duchess, you can use your polish material, you can use your Ankara. Any material can do this, not only Aso-oke. You can use any material to do this type of cap. So you are not limited to Aso-oke alone. Just that for this material, this is what I have, and this is what I feel like using. So then there are many methods. You can see that I only have two. I first of all did two for this one before I now attach the third Aso-oke. So this is another way of making it so that you will be able to get your right side and your wrong side. You can do it like this. You first of all do the two. We call it awe in Yoruba land, awe Aso-oke. So the two awe is what you first of all do. After that, then you attach the third one so that you will be able to get your right side and your wrong side perfectly. If you did not want to do the former one that I just did, the three, I can still do the three at a stretch. But if you are confused, you can first of all do two, then later on you attach the third piece. So the neck, the head circumference is what I'm marking out here, which is 23 inches. Unfold, it will be 11.5. Then you're going to curve it up like so. So if you use 2 hours, you just go like that, the way I did my hand. But if you did 3, this is how you're going to curve it up. You can do 2. 2 will also be fine. Just that the ruffles in the middle will not, by the time you finish the cap, will not be much. If you don't want the ruffles to be much, you just do 2. then it will be very, very fine and smart. So then I'll just stitch. This is, I have put the edge circumference. Then I'll just go ahead and stitch like so, and go ahead and trim out excess allowance. Then after that, turn it out to the right side. Then after you turn it out, this is what you have, and our Zara cap is almost ready. So the next thing to do is to get our bow and attach it to the joint, the back, the side that we have joining. There is no back, there is no front. So the side that has joining is where you are going to attach the bow, just to cover the joining line. So I will just attach it, just tack it down. So tacking will be preferable so that it will be in place. So like I told you that you can use any material to make this type of cap. You're not limited to Aso-oke alone. You can use duchess, you can use, in fact, silk materials, you can use polish materials, you can use cotton, polish cotton, that's what I mean. You can use any material of your choice. You can use Ankara to make this type of cap. And we have almost gotten to the end of the tutorial. So you can see the ruffles in the middle. It depends on how voluminous you want it to be. So you determine this by the width of your cap. And to design this cap, you can use floral materials. You can use applique to design the cap. It's not limited to a bow alone. So you can use other materials to design the cap. You can see my own that I'm wearing. You can see it's very, very beautiful, and this is the result of what we just made. So if you like this video, give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and also share this video. And I will see you in my next video. Until then, take care of yourself. Bye for now.